So objective bits regarding introduction and preparation and properties of alcohols. So first bit ma, the number of primary alcoholic groups in glycol. So primary alcohol groups, OH functional group linked with primary carbon. Okay, so that is primary alcohol group. So ethylene glycol, this is ethylene glycol. And this is primary carbon, carbon linked with another carbon. This is also primary carbon, primary, primary. So number of primary alcoholic groups are 2. Next, an isomer of ethanol is. So generally alcohols are isomeric with ethers. Okay, so ethyl alcohol, C2H5OH. Okay, it is isomeric with dimethyl ether, CH3OCH3. Both are functional isomers having same molecular formula, C2H6O, and one having alcohol functional group and another one having ether functional group. Okay, so isomer of ethanol is dimethyl ether. Next, if the boiling point of ethanol molecular weight is 46 is 78 degree centigrade, the boiling point of diethyl ether molecular weight is 74. So ethanol, ethyl alcohol, its boiling point is 78 degree centigrade. So its boiling point is higher than ethers, alkyl halides and corresponding alkanes. Why? Because ethyl alcohol gets soluble in water and it forms intermolecular hydrogen bonds. Okay, so due to the formation of intermolecular hydrogen bond, its boiling point is higher. Okay, so boiling point of diethyl ether, that must be less than 78 degree centigrade. Okay, so see these options: 100 degree centigrade, 78 degree centigrade, 86 degree centigrade and 34 degree centigrade. Okay, so less than 78 degree centigrade, option D is correct. Okay, next, 1 mole of ethyl acetate on treatment with an excess of lithium aluminium hydride in dry ether and subsequent acidification produces. So this is one of the preparation method of ethyl alcohol by the reduction of esters. Okay, ethyl acetate, that is ester. Okay, CH3COOC2H5, it undergoes reduction in presence of lithium aluminium hydride reducing agent in dry ether. We get 2 moles of ethyl alcohol. Okay, so here option C, 2 moles of ethyl alcohol. Okay, next, glucose is converted into ethyl alcohol by maltase, zymase, invertase, diastage. Okay, so glucose in presence of enzymes converts into ethyl alcohol. This is called fermentation process. Okay, so both from starch and molasses. So starch, from starch we get 2 moles of glucose, and from molasses, that is from sucrose, we get 1 mole of glucose and 1 mole of fructose. Okay, so either 2 moles of glucose or 1 mole of glucose or fructose from molasses. So they, in presence of zymase enzyme, okay, converts into ethyl alcohol. Okay, so glucose C6H12O6 in presence of zymase, enzyme zymase. So this is the enzyme zymase. It forms ethyl alcohol along with the liberation of carbon dioxide. And this is called wash or wort. Ethyl alcohol, this is formed here, is called wash or wort. Okay, next, sixth bit. rectified spirit can be converted into absolute alcohol by distilling with. So from glucose in presence of jimase we get ethyl alcohol, that is called 6 to 10% ethyl alcohol, which is also called as wash or wort. Okay, so from wash or wort on distillation, fractional distillation, we get rectified spirit. Okay, so rectified spirit further undergoes distillation with the calcium oxide. Okay, then we get 100% alcohol, which is called absolute alcohol. Okay, so distillation with the calcium oxide, rectified spirit distillation with the calcium oxide produces 100% alcohol, which is called absolute alcohol. Okay, so option D is correct here. Okay, next, slow decomposition of complex organic compounds into simple ones by enzymes is known as, okay, so slow decomposition of complex organic compounds into simpler units, small units. Okay, so that is called as, that phenomena is called as fermentation. This is purely conceptual bit nana. Okay, so slow decomposition of complex organic compounds into simpler units by enzymes. Okay, so that is fermentation process. So starch, molasses, sucrose, maltose, okay, so they decomposes into simpler units like glucose and fructose. From glucose and fructose we can prepare ethyl alcohol. So the process is called fermentation process. Next, identify A and B in the following reaction. So here ethyl chloride in presence of A forms ethyl alcohol, and same reaction takes place when we use B reagent. Okay, so here ethyl chloride in presence of aqueous potassium hydroxide nucleophilic substitution reaction. This is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. So ethyl chloride in presence of aqueous potassium hydroxide or silver hydroxide, it produces ethyl alcohol. Okay, so both aqueous potassium hydroxide, ethyl chloride converts into ethyl alcohol. Okay, next, ethyl chloride in presence of silver hydroxide, it also converts into ethyl alcohol. Okay, so this one, aqueous KOH and AgOH. Next, ethyl alcohol acts as nucleophile when it reacts with the, okay, so during esterification reaction ethyl alcohol reacts with acetic acid in presence of acid catalyst. Okay, so that reaction, in that reaction ethyl alcohol acts like a nucleophile. Okay, so esterification reaction, C2H5OH plus CH3COOH in presence of acid, we get CH3COO, C2H5 and H2. This is esterification reaction. Okay, so here C2H5OH, okay, so it acts like nucleophile. Okay, so here nucleophile is C2H5O minus is nucleophile. Okay, so nucleophilic substitution reaction. Next, 23 grams of sodium will react with methanol to give. So reaction between methyl alcohol and sodium. Okay, sodium metal replaces hydrogen from methyl alcohol. So we get sodium methoxide and half mole of hydrogen. Okay, so 23 grams of sodium will react with methanol to give half mole of hydrogen. So this is the answer. Okay, and for this ninth one, D is the answer, CH3COH and H+.